Remember the movie Avatar? I most definitely do, even though sometimes I wish I didn't. Even though, you know, it was beautifully visualized with state-of-the-art graphics, and I watched it, I believe, at IMAX at the time in 3D. It was glorious. Oh, so beautiful, even though I'm pretty sure IMAX doesn't do 3D at the moment. But, hey, that's a whole different discussion. So why am I talking about the movie Avatar? Well, it has to do with the fact that the Na'vi, the species in that particular movie that live on the planet Pandora, orbiting the Alpha Centauri Alpha system. Well, Alpha? Proxima Centauri? Let's go with that. They're a hive mind because they all connect to each other through their wonderful hair strands to every single species on the planet. And what is it all being held together by? Well, it is, of course, the Tree of Life. Yes, the Tree of Life, the hive mind origin that comes with Utopia. That's right, it comes with Utopia. If you do not have Utopia, you cannot play as hive minds, and therefore you cannot have the Tree of Life. Sorry to say, but that is sadly how it goes down. It's a interesting little modifier that you can attach to your empire, and it does a lot of cool things. First of all, you get a tree. A big tree. It's apparently gives life. I'm sure there's a giant mountain of unobtainium right below it, ready to be harvested by unscrupulous megacorporations that are just sitting around. No, there's no events for megacorps trying to dig out your tree of life and trying to monetize it. Don't worry about it, sadly. But it does have a couple of cool modifiers attached to it, as well as gameplay mechanics. I've set up this wonderful little hive mind here called the Pandoran Collective from the world of Pandora, and of course I called them the Na'vi. They look exactly the same, right? Like there's blue on this thing, I believe. They got six limbs, like the people on Pandora, or at least all the aliens on that planet, except for the Pandorans themselves. Because, you know, that makes biological sense. So you start out, it's a hive mind. Oh, you start out as a hive mind. What can I say? There's nothing really special about it except, you know, it's a hive mind. You don't get consumer goods. There is only one personality, which is you. And of course, the avatars, that is you, which is the leadership. For some reason, that's a thing. Anyway, we got ourselves our capital world here of Pandora. Now, the Tree of Life is active here, but there is no modifier on the planetary screen to be seen, sadly enough. That would be a really nice paradox if that was the case, but sometimes we simply cannot have nice things. No, the Tree of Life is nicely tucked away underneath planetary features. There it is. The Tree of Life, it is super powerful. It increases pop growth speed by 15%, which in combination with things like nutritional surpluses, as well as the inherent pop growth speed of hive minds to begin with, is extremely powerful. In addition, society research from jobs, plus 10%. That's a free tech upgrade there, right at the get-go. And finally, we get housing and, of course, the maximum agricultural districts, plus 4. This means that you're going to be swimming in agricultural districts, and this also means that you may want to go for a wet planet approach, either the ocean world, the forest world, continental world, or the jungle worlds that you can get. Just try to stay away from the mineral worlds or the cold ones, that is. Or the arid worlds, which have more energy. It's still nice to get those, but hey, what can one do, right? Yeah, hive minds in general are just particularly great when it comes to these sort of things. I went a bit unruly here as well because, well, Empire Sprawl doesn't really matter, and this is basically just a free point. So yeah, the Tree of Life, it spawns on a planet, and you get it. It's really cool. However, you can get more of these by planting saplings. How does that work? Let's find out. So as your colony ship is approaching its next destination, which is, of course, this here ocean world, we will find ourselves with the prospect of, well, colonization. However, we will be seeing a bit of a problem right away, which we are going to need to address at some point. And that is, of course, the following. It is the No Tree of Life modifier. With the No Tree of Life modifier, it means that all planetary build speed has been reduced by 50%. Pops will produce resources less. That's all pops. By minus 25%, upkeep will be increasing by 10, and stability will decrease. However, once a planet is done, a sapling will automatically be deployed, which also increases pop growth speed by 10%. Society research, once again, 10%, housing, and maximum agricultural districts. It's very similar to the actual Tree of Life in that particular case. It is actually, it's a bit of a downgrade. You don't get the plus 15% pop growth, but hey, it's still pretty darn good. So, at this point, what do you do? How can you expand from this? Well, you just continue going, right? You get a flat bonus to every single planet that you colonize, which is great. But what happens if a planet loses, of course, its Tree of Life? Well, once again, you will be given this here modifier, where basically all planetary build speed will be reduced, which is obviously extremely bad. So sooner or later, one of your neighbors will start singing the wonderful tunes of the, well, the hills are alive with the sound of Anschluss, and will declare war on you. So what do you do in this particular case? Well, first of all, you scream, because in this particular case, it's a friggin' Bloodborne at next door, so the Fnatic purifiers. But also, you're going to need to start protecting your planets, because your saplings are going to be in a bit of trouble if you do not watch out. So yeah, in this particular case, our Bloodborne are just quietly ramming into the enemy systems and are quickly on their way to, of course, the nearest world that is populated, because there is a delicious sapling over there, and I do hear that it does go well with a nice Cabernet Sauvignon. So we're gonna go and kill that one and see what happens to the Tree of Life sapling. Now, as you can see in this particular case, the Blood guys have managed to take our capital, which just happens to have our Tree of Life on it. As you can see, it's still in one place. It's not really doing anything. And there appears to be no decision to uproot said Tree of Life. Therefore, all the promises by the devs that saying if you would lose the Tree of Life or it gets destroyed, it would be severe consequences for your empire. Well, if we quickly take a look at all of our other planets, or at least country modifiers, there's nothing here about losing our Tree of Life. Or, yeah, we still have our saplings. It's still transplanted, but it doesn't really do anything. So that's a shame. Now, sadly, there's only one way to effectively remove the infestation that is, of course, the Tree of Life. And that is by increasing the devastation on a planet that has said Tree of Life to about 50%. As you can see, orbital bombardment of massive damage, especially in the Armageddon variety, should be enough. And as you can see, the Tree of Life over here is, we're bombing it. Of course we're bombing it. And as soon as we hit 50 devastation, it's gonna be the end of that abomination over here. Yeah, they're not gonna be having a lot of fun in this hive mind, because, well, sadly, their soul tree, or whatever they call it, will no longer be there. And poof, there it goes. The Tree of Life is gone. What does this do for the hive mind species? Well, let's take a look, shall we? Well, sadly, there is no empire-wide modifier for losing your Tree of Life, which, again, is a real shame. I really wish it was the case, because really losing that origin part of you it would be really, really sad. And sadly, it's just not there. It just removes the deposit of the Tree of Life. There is no empire-wide modifier for the life tree, which is a real shame. And yeah, that pretty much sums up the Tree of Life. Still, pretty cool bonuses overall. The original Tree of Life gives you massive bonuses, and if you don't have the Tree of Life, it gives you a massive malice, which is a real shame. But like I said, if you lose your capital world as well as your Tree of Life, then you don't really get anything massive. There is no massive impact to your empire in general, which I feel is a real missed opportunity here. Still, you still have your saplings, so you can do something with those, I guess. But I'm sure then that someday somebody somewhere is going to bring a fleet over your planet, set it to 50 devastation, and you lose your saplings as well. Thus wraps up the Tree of Life, the only origin currently available for Hive Minds. I'm sure the future will bring more with more flavor and new gameplay mechanics. I'm sure the developers have more in mind. But in the meantime, I want to thank everybody for watching, and especially my patrons for making this video possible. If it wasn't for you, well, things would be not all that great. Let's put it that way. You know, it's I love my wife very, very, very much, and our relationship is like the bedrock of my being. But sometimes, man, the discussions, the requests that she has, it's just a Patreon makes those possible. So if you want to get involved, feel free. It's good. We want to get a tricycle for our daughter, basically, and that's what she's been nagging me about. But regardless, thank you so much for watching. And of course, if you want to pick up Utopia, there is a link for that in the description. It's the only way to play with Hive Minds. It is available on the Paradox Store. Once again, if you use that link to the Paradox Store, I will get a cut of the proceeds as well. But until next time, take good care of yourselves, and as always, naughty tentacles.